Hello children, welcome back to physics class. So we were discussing the chapter force and motion. In the last video we have discussed the types of motion and simple pendulum, right? So in the simple pendulum we have seen the length of the pendulum and extreme position, and when do you say one oscillation is completed, right? And then in today's class we'll see some more terms related to simple pendulum. We'll see some terms related to simple pendulum. The first one is time period. Okay, the time period of a simple pendulum is the time taken by it to complete one oscillation, that is one complete to and fro motion. Okay, the its SI unit is second. Next is amplitude. Okay, the amplitude of a simple pendulum is the maximum displacement of the bob of the simple pendulum from its mean position on either of the extreme position. Okay. So its SI unit is meter. Next is frequency. Frequency of a simple pendulum is the number of oscillation made by the pendulum in 1 second. Okay, so its SI unit is hertz. Frequency is nothing but the number of oscillation made in 1 second. Okay, and what is the SI unit of frequency? It is hertz. Okay, the time period and the frequency are inversely proportional to each other, that is time period is equals to 1 divided by frequency, and when you want to find the frequency it is 1 divided by time period. So when you come to the school you can do the activity on simple pendulum. Okay, see the factors affecting the time period of a simple pendulum. The time period of a simple pendulum depends on the length of the pendulum and not on the mass of the bob or amplitude. The factors which is affecting the time period of the simple pendulum is the length of the pendulum, okay, not the mass or the amplitude. Okay, next we'll see scalar and vector quantity. Okay, so you know that the motion of an object can be described by terms such as distance, displacement, speed, velocity and acceleration. These physical quantities which are used to describe the motion of an object can be divided into two categories. Okay, the quantity is either a vector quantity or a scalar quantity. Okay, so let's see what is this scalar quantity and vector quantity. Okay, a scalar quantity is a physical quantity that has only magnitude. Okay, a scalar quantity which are fully described by magnitude alone. Okay, for example, mass, length, time, temperature, volume and density, etc. Okay, these are the scalar quantity. The next one is a vector quantity. A vector is a physical quantity that has both magnitude and direction. So as you know, the scalar involves only the magnitude, but the vector is a physical quantity that has both magnitude and direction. For example, position, displacement, velocity, acceleration, momentum, force, etc. Okay, these are the vector quantities. As we go further you will know the difference between the scalar and vector quantity. Okay, let's see the distance and displacement. To understand the motion of a body, we need to know the position of a body from a given point of reference with respect to time. So when I ask you what is the distance between your school and to your home, you may say that it is 5 kilometers, right? So there may be another way or a direct way by which you cannot come by vehicle. Okay, there may not be a road, but there may be direct way that may be like the distance of 3 kilometers, right? So there is a difference between distance and displacement. Okay, the distance is 5 kilometer and the displacement I say it is a 3 kilometer. So what is the difference between the distance and displacement? Okay, let's see that. So distance is the actual path covered by a body irrespective of its direction. Okay, it is a scalar quantity. Okay, it does not depend on the direction. So it is a scalar quantity. Distance is the actual path covered, the path whichever you covered, that is the distance. Okay, next is a displacement. Displacement is the shortest distance traveled by a body from its initial position to its final position in a particular direction. So here there is a direction involved, so it is a vector quantity. So let's take an example and understand the distance and displacement. So as you can see in this picture, a boy goes from tree A to सी. ओके, थ्रू दिस वे ही गोज फ्रॉम ए टू बी एंड देन बी टू सी. ओके, सो व्हाट इज द डिस्टेंस ही हैज ट्रैवल, दैट इज 4 meter प्लस 3 meter, टोटली 7 meter. द डिस्टेंस दैट ही हैज कवर्ड इज 7 meters. ओके, सो the displacement is the shortest distance between the initial and the final position. So what is this initial position? It is A. The final position is C. The shortest distance will be this, right? So the shortest distance will be 5 meter. Okay, that is the displacement. Okay, so now we might have understood what is the distance and displacement. Distance is nothing but the actual path covered by the body, and the displacement is the shortest distance from the initial to the final position. So when you are taking from A to B, the shortest distance will be this one. Okay, so you can go around in a curved path and can come, that will be your distance. Okay, and distance is a scalar quantity, whereas the displacement is a vector quantity. SI unit of distance and displacement is meter. For both, the SI unit is meter. So now you have understood the distance and displacement. So here, a boy starts from point A and he goes to B and C and again D and he comes back to A. So what will be his distance? That is, A to B it is 3, 3 plus 5, 3 plus 5 is 8 meter, 8 meter plus 3, 11, 11 plus 5 is 16. So the distance traveled from point A to again point A, it is 16 meters, right? So what will be the displacement? I said displacement is the shortest distance between the initial point to the final point. So initially he starts from the point A and again he is coming back to A. So what will be the displacement? So initial and the final are in the same position, right? So the shortest distance, there is no shortest distance between the initial and final. The initial and the final are at the same position. Therefore the displacement will be zero. So now you might have understood what is the distance and displacement. Your homework is to write what is a frequency, amplitude and time period in a simple pendulum, and what is a definition for distance and displacement. Okay, write it in your homework book.